vehicle to, but there were some extra charges. Some of your personal stays required pounding on the rock. Lord Cook, guess I don't need to ask who got detention again. Could you turn that by your manners, say hello to our guests?
Hello, Mrs. Pingleton.
Thank you, Penny.
Hello, Mrs. Pingleton. I mean, Mother.
Teenagers, they just love watching that Gordy Collins.
The language. It ain't mine. Dancing to that color music.
Don't be silly. It ain't color. The TV's black and white.
Want to be one of the nicest kids in town?
There will be no cutting school in this house.
Oh, Mrs. Turnblad!
Honey,
what?
Go tell your mother she wants you.
She does. Oh, I better hurry. Bye, Mrs. Turnblad! Bye, Jason!
Whoa, rush hour traffic. Hi, ladies. Since I got that new shipment of exploding bubblegum, business downstairs is... Boom! How are my two funny honey?
Come over, stop!
You're the funny one.
Hey, Daddy, tomorrow I'm auditioning to dance on a TV show.
You're going to have to go a lot further than that to get around me, young lady. No one is auditioning for anything. And what did I tell you about that hair? All rounded up like a teenage Jezebel.
Mother, you are so 50s. You are not First Lady Jackie B. Kennedy wrapped her hair.
By the way, no First Lady, are you? She's a hair hopper, that's what she is. And it got her put in detention. Again. Talk to her. Girls like Tracy, people like us, you know what I'm saying. They don't put people like us on television except to be laughed at.
Tracy, this TV thing, you really want it?
It's my dream, Dad.
And you go for it! This is America, babe. You gotta think big to be big.
Being big is not the problem,
Wilbur. When I was your age, my parents begged me to run away with the circus, but I said, no, that's what you want. I've got dreams of my own. I dreamt of opening a chain of joke shops worldwide. So, okay, I've still only got one, but someday if I can figure out a way to keep the air from leaking out of my sofa-sized whoopee cushion, I'm gonna make a noise heard around the world! You follow your dream, baby. I'm grabbing an orange crush and head back down to the Hardy Har Hut. I've got my dream, and I want
to move your mouth, baby! Rebel Wilbur!
Thanks, Dad!
Tracy, where are you coming out here? I'm facing hampers of laundry, and my diet pill is wearing off! Want to be famous? Learn how to get blood out of car upholstery. That's a skill you can take right from the back. You think I wanted to spend my whole life washing and ironing other people's clothes? Oh no. I wanted to design them. I wanted to be the biggest thing in brassieres. Hey, you better be careful what you wish for. That's our cold thing.
But all I was doing was watching Courtney Collins over at Tracy.
Did I forbid you from listening to race music? Oh, if the police ever locate your father, he'll punish you good. Your dancing was atrocious today. Amber, now I'm willing to lie, cheat, and steal to win you that Miss Hairspray crown, but you gotta work with me. Now, let me add that zip.
That is no way to treat clean clothes. What made you own Edna's Occidental Laundry? Will you be ready?
Hope not.
Don't contradict me! Don't disobey me!
Don't even think about going to that.
Stop, don't, no, please.
Carnival girls were all such scabs. Miles, this town has gone downhill since I was crowned Miss Baltimore Crabs.
Oh my God, I can imagine what this place would look like. This isn't it. Hi there. Am I too late to audition?
Not too late, dear, just too much.
Look, it's late.
Meg Larkin. So near and yet so gorgeous.
It's got my hands all over me. I don't know how Rock Hudson stands in it. Oh. Excuse me, little darling. I hope I didn't dent your deal.
My heart was prepared when he tapped me, and now
I'm sorry. I'm just a little nervous. Can I start over? I assure you I'll calm down. But after I have a heart attack.
Attention.
is a rainbow experience.
Hey, what's that,
Steph? Oh, this one here? I call this one Painting Place After Midnight. And I use it to attract the opposite.
Jack and Jason, I'm not.
Hit it!
And
do my ultra quad?
Without the power behind the throne, princes of I know, I've been following.
you and I are going to have a talk about crooners. We can learn a lot from the mistakes of Miss Debbie Reynolds.
Here it goes again.
Hello? Yes, this is Tracy Fernblatt.
Hello, Mr. Pinky.
Mr. Pinky? The Mr. Pinky? As in Mr. Pinky's Pepsi Hideaway? Quantity clothes for quantity gals. Not Mr. Pinky!
You want to hire me as your exclusive spokesgirl and fashion effigy?
Ah! 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 No clue.
Okay, well, that sounds very flattering, Mr. Pinky, but I'm afraid that all of my business must go through my agent. It'd be our pleasure. We'll be right down there. Thank you, Mr. Pinky, bye!
An agent? I don't know any agents. How about a nice bail bondsman?
Oh, no, put this thing down. I'm taking my new agent to the Happy Highway and Mama, I'm in the town!
Who? Me? Can't you turn down? Fame has gone to your head and left you wacky. You need a top shelf professional. Now, who handled the Gabor sister? Well, who didn't?
Mama, there's a great big world out there that I knew nothing about. And
I'll be right there to ask you that what you want, and together we'll claw your way to the top. But can't we do it over the phone? I haven't been out of this apartment since Mamie Eisenhower rolled her hose and bobbed her bang.
Thank you. the room, students! Brace yourselves for scattered dodgeball! I got balls!
Kathy Speak told me she heard Tracy was in the back seat of a car with two boys once. Playing tussle hockey in the news.
Is it true they put her in special ed?
Yep, Tracy Turner Law is a tramp and she's retarded. That's right, she's fast and slow at the same time. Hey, Gordon, how could you kiss that beehive buffalo right on the air?
It didn't mean anything ever, it was just a cool way to end the song.
Hey, here they come! Special ed!
Snicker, snicker, snicker.
Steer, steer.
That ain't cool, Fender, knock it off. Try to ask the grown up.
Oh, Link. If fate forces you to throw the ball at me today,
see you. You got a prayer for me too? This game can get pretty vicious.
Well, what is Garrett Oswald anyway?
Sort of like a protest round. When the bully show up, you better scatter and dodge.
Thank you.
Miss Mona Hale!
Hey, Mom, I brought some friends.
Who did you what? Who be at responding, sir?
Always nice to see you, Miss Mona Mel.
I'm Patty Little Pinkerton, and I'm very pleased. I'm scared to be here.
You're welcome, dear president. This is just so afro-tastic! Can I just say how thrilled I am to meet you? I'm Tracy. I am Sweetie's friend.
Oh, yes, indeed, I've seen you, Sweetie, all over furniture.
Oh, well, gee, thanks. Well, the only reason I'm even on the show is because of your son. What do we all feel like this together on television?
You think we have a problem? We plead it.
But enough talk to Cameron Dad, so let's play some five and seek up in here.
Break the barrier, then
Well, it's all parks like Rosa Parks.
Tom, it ain't that easy. This ain't park easy. What if they call the cops? People could get hurt.
And we'll all walk out. Look, there's me, and there's Lincoln. Hey, I'm sure you can get the others, and without dancers, they got no show.
You got that right.
What a decision. Your girl's got vision.
We've always tried to teach you to do what's right.
And give correct change.
Tracy, you can't do this. You're new to the council. You'll be blackballed and thrown off the show for sure.
That's why we're all going to do this together.
Not me.
Do you think the segregation is wrong?
Look, I like these people, but whether or not they're on TV is going to get me a recording contract. That came out wrong. Look, I've been singing and dancing and smiling on that show for 3 years, waiting for it to lead to my break. And you've got everything. Brains, talent, personality. Me? I've got one chance to get seen nationwide. Saturday night is everything I've worked for, and I'm not going to throw it away. Now, come on, I'm leaving. You got to go, too.
No!
Thank you. Thank you. Oh.
Yes, Mr. Figgy. I understand you have an empire to protect. All right. I'll deter the outfits. The petty fans, too. I scarcely wore them twice. But, Mr. Figgy, she's just a little girl. And little girls make mistakes. If they didn't, where would other little girls come from? It is too bad. Goodbye, Mr. Pink. Wilbur, this is a real viral moment. My stomach is in knots, my nerves are on edge. I can't calm down. There are names who women who've abandoned their daughters and they've been arrested for attempting to integrate an after school sock off my television show. Yes. There are names. And Hallmark does not make a card for any of them.
You can't worry about people calling you names. You know how many times I've been called crazy? But I say, yeah, crazy, crazy like a loon. Anyway, we haven't abandoned her. In fact, I've got just what she needs here. Stand back. What do you think? Isn't it a doozy?
Impressive. But how is that little thing supposed to help our Tracy?
You'll be surprised.
Oh, sure. You're a visionary inventor, saving the day. Tracy's a teen idol, reshaping the world. What am I? I had a dream too, you know. I used to make all my own clothes, remember? Until I wandered beyond the boundaries of the largest McCall's factory. Still, I was good that one day I put out my own line of queen-size dress pants.
You were good.
Yeah, what are they getting? 20 years later, I'm still washing and mending and ironing everyone else's clothes.
One day,
don't get me, Wilbur. My time has come and gone. I'm like a half-filled book of green stamps. Beyond redemption. I suddenly feel so old.
Oh, nonsense, dog. Your spry is a slinky. Whenever I'm near you, it's like grabbing hold of a giant joint buzzer.
Just timeless to me.
Oh, and then it gets
all right. broken down Chevy. All you need is a fresh coat of paint.
Yeah, and you have me going heavy. You're fat and old, but baby, boring you ain't.
Some folks look at it, but we never pray. Cause we know that time is our friend. Yeah, it's plain to say, you're stuck with me until the bitter end. And we got sick, so we're the lid off the Templar family tree. You always hit the spot, big shot. You're timeless to me.
You'll always be too sure, but of all, you are timeless to me.
You'll always be first string.
Wait a day, day.
Oh, that's better than a flu shot. I have to wait online at Costco.
You are timeless.
do with me? All this time, I thought Amber and I were a team, and she and her mother were just using me to make her look popular. I feel like such an idiot. I know a beluga like me isn't worthy of a groundbreaking extremist like you. It's a little scuffed from Amber throwing it in my face. I told her I'd rather be with you. I did. So, would you consider wearing my ring? To lose me or to lose myself? Some kid named Milton wrote that in the third floor boys' room.
I was
Who's at the back door?
My baby. And can you get her?
Yes, ma'am.
She was got a girlfriend.
There's no care to run her home. I had to get away from a nasty ass mom.
Show me the world.
something there. Say, don't I know you?
I just don't. I'm a total stranger.
You?
Damn.
All right, riot squad. I want everybody out of the lobby and up here pronto. What is this, some kind of Trojan horse? Oh, of course. And what's inside your jailbird, darling?
Not a chance.
Well, if she's hiding in that can, she'll rot in that can. Guard, if anyone so much as touches that thing, open fire.
Understood, Dad.
You witness that about tussle, you're one clever woman, I'll say that.
Get out. We're back to Courtney on camera one and three, two.
And now for the talent portion of the competition, where the front runner gals present a dance of their own creation. Ooh, presently it appears that Amber Von Tussle and Tracy Turnblad are neck and neck. But since according to the latest police bulletins, Miss Turnblad is still at large.
I'm very large.
Yeah. Our Miss Hairspray might just be a foregone conclusion. Still, our rules say the contestant has to dance for it. Are you ready, Amber?
I'm ready, Amber.
Yeah!
So when you turn blood, I declare you Miss Teenage Hairspray 1962!
Can't do with that halo, honey. You'll have to rip it from my cold, dead hands. That'll work.
Remember,
you can keep it, but counting on the hearts meant something a lot more important.
Would that happen to be me?
Well, of course you late. But I also have a graduate degree in musicology with a minor in ethnic studies. And if something else I'd like to say, the Corny Collins Show is now and forevermore.
Here's history right before your eyes. Television will never be the same.
This is marvelous. The phones are going crazy. The whole country's watching. Even the governor called. He's enjoying the show so much, he's granted a pardon to Tracy plus a full scholarship to Essex Community College. You cannot buy this kind of publicity, Velma. You are a genius.
I am. Oh, yes, I am.
Ultra Clutch is about to launch an entirely new line of products, and I want this woman to head the campaign.
Really?
It comes with offices, a company car, and a multi-figured salary.
Really?
Velma Von Tussel, you're the newly appointed vice president of Ultra Glow Beauty Products for Women of Color. America would like your YouTube kids sing our new theme song. I think I can get you a recording contract. Whoa, Wendy, break!
Hey, excuse me. Gotta get I'm in the show.
And so are you now.
I love it. All right, see you in a minute.
This may not be the right moment since we're on national TV and all, but Tracy, if I don't kiss you now, I just might bust a gut.
Well, we wouldn't want you to hurt yourself, now would we?
That's my girl. This could be the largest novelty item ever erected. Fire!
Because I like the way I am. Good evening. My name is Teresa Hines Carey. Here's next year's ketchup bottle. Thank you for coming to my little production of I Am My Own Wife. Well, for I'm thrilled to be out of my square and in New York for the holidays of coming up Christmas and Hanukkah and, of course, in my case, Halloween. But in the finishing time, I don't know what to wear. I'm going to throw a tarpaulin over this. I've always a rain delay. Appeals to their audiences to help us raise money for our favorite charity, which is Broadway Cares, Equity Fights AIDS. It started as a very small charity for the theatrical community for people whose lives were affected by the disease. And of course, as the disease grew and the government stepped out and the private sector stepped in, it became a much larger organization. Now it's national. Now it deals with people who are not in the theater at all, but whose lives are affected by the disease. And unlike a lot of charities, it has remained lean and mean. So every dollar that you actually give to Broadway Cares goes to somebody whose life really has been affected by the disease, as opposed to other charities, you know, where it goes to buy vermilions for the reception area. I've got benefits for all of them. I mean, please, find a bit, I can tell you everything. I've been there. I've done every benefit. So what I'm telling you, Broadway Cares, is it's worth your money. Now, I know you're sitting out there, standing out there, asking yourselves, what can I do to help you, a large person in red dress? As you plot your way to Times Square. Well, we have a number of things. Our cast is assembling behind you, circling you, like the Greeks circled the Romans, or the Romans circled the Greeks. I don't know. I have to see the Oliver Stone picture. All I know is Colin Farrell nails everybody. And would you if you were Colin Farrell? And so they're out there now with their little charge things and buckets, and they're waiting. And we thought maybe you would like to enhance your hairspray experience with some of these items. First of all, a hairspray poster. This has been signed by everybody in the company. This is so much easier than standing outside and trolling for the cast as they come to the stage door. It's got everybody's how much? Oh, Madam Chairwoman. 60. Thank you. 60. We're all on the same page. It's like Fox News election night coverage. Make it up as we go along. Hey, one guam. 60. Okay, next. This is the CD, Broadway's Greatest Gifts, Carols for a Cure, Volume 6. Every show on Broadway, the cast has recorded a holiday song or a Christmas song to put on this CD, brand new this year. I can't wait to see what Golden My Ear sings. Shalom Santa. From Toba, live in Boca. We can't pass this up. Here we have, that's 20, it's a 20 buck. Here we have a can of Ultra Clutch hairspray. Hairspray's hairspray of choice, signed by everybody in the company. This is a fabulous thing to put on your mantle next to your Golden Globe Award. I'm sure you all have them. Or People's Choice. Who doesn't have one of those? I mean, even I have one. Never mind. They give an award for the People's Choice game show. Can you believe it? The plaque is worth more than anything we gave away on the show. Ultra Clutch. How much is the Ultra Clutch pan, ladies and gentlemen? $20, says the lovely Carol Merrill.
Are in the back lobby, not with the people with the buckets.
They're in the back lobby.
Where you can get those.
But the back lobby, where Elaine Stritch is also still hanging out. 2 years ago, finishing her speech. This is the original AIDS ribbon, the red ribbon, the first fundraising gift that we came up with, actually. And it's got the hairspray cloisonné pin with the hairspray ransom note logo on it. This is actually quite an important item because this was started like 20-something years ago, and we're still selling them because the disease hasn't gone away, even though many people think it has. And when you wear it, it indicates your awareness of that fact and its solidarity with the hundreds of thousands of people who are affected by it. Here we have a keychain, also in the ever-popular hairspray cloisonné ransom note. For those of you who have anything left valuable.
And these are about $10 a piece.
Oh, these are about $10 a piece. I would wear one, but as you know, I already look like Barbara Bush felt in the Fire Island Raspberry Patch. Anything else? Lovely Carol Merrill, if nothing else, we're going to do a book about them. We were molested by Bob Barker. My darling daughter. Sorry, she's having a private moment. Now, if none of this appeals to you, putting her box away. If none of this appeals to you, our cast members are out there with buckets. If you would drop some money in the bucket, if everybody here just put $1 in the bucket, that would be $1,500, which would be a great head start for the holiday season for Broadway Theater. So thank you in advance for your generosity, and I am now going to get a phone call from Bill O'Reilly.